Drug use started for me when I was a senior in high school. Beyond that, I had maybe smoked a few joints, drank a few beers, but nothing to the extent that it became.
My dad hurt his back at work. He had surgery, and then even when his back was better, he just couldn't get back to life, you know?
My grandmother was, she had cancer, and she got pain pills. And I had met a guy, and he introduced me to pain pills. And I was unaware of what they were, what they could do to you. I just tried to fit in. And that was the worst mistake I've ever made.
It wasn't because of the injury, we figured out. It was because he became addicted to pills.
Opioids, along with all other drugs, alcohol, anything that you can imagine, has completely turned my life upside down. It took me to a dark place. I experienced a lot of things.
I hated it when he was high, but I hated it when he wasn't, because he was even meaner. I just told myself it wasn't him, that it was the pain making him mean. But really, it was the dope messing up with his brain.
At first, when I started to use, I had no consequences for my actions. I hadn't really hit adulthood. I didn't have children. I wasn't on my own. So it didn't really affect me outwardly as much as it did inside.
We went through a lot. Court, social workers, foster care.
I felt like it didn't matter what I'd done. I just wanted to get high, as high as I could get, to not think about it.
Dad said he still needed them. I kind of thought so too, but he also seemed to hurt more, even after his back seemed better. So that was it. That was the excuse for shooting up, that he had to find some way to function.
And I remember right before I got put in jail and I got clean for the final time, I remember locking myself in a room and just crying in a fetal position, praying that God would, help me do something. I couldn't do it on my own. I was too broken.
There would be needles and spoons, people everywhere, all the time.
It was a struggle. I wanted to do it, but I just couldn't. I couldn't take that first initial step. And I wanted it. I thought about it every day, but I was just so broken. I couldn't make that first step. If it wasn't for the court system and an amazing judge out of Allen County, Scottsville, Kentucky, and she sent me here. And if you ask me, it was God's will for me to be here all along.
Now he helps other people stay clean. His counselor got him to talk to people that need the same kind of surgery he had to have. He talks to them about therapy and stuff instead of taking all the pills that only made him seem worse. He is trying to use his bad experience to make someone else's experience better to learn from.
A drug rehab center here in Corbin, Kentucky. It's for pregnant women. It's called the Independence House. They accepted me. I was able to find myself there. I was able to be a mom and learn things that were going to help me succeed for the rest of my life and staying clean. My life today is completely different. I'm a completely different person. And I have things today that I never could imagine that I'd ever have again.